हंस दो, इधर आ सकते हो, जो भी हंसना चाहता है। देखो राज और मैं और केके, ये एक त्रिकोण रहा है, मतलब कहते हैं चीनी चाय की पत्ती और दूध अलग नहीं किया जा सकता। और हम दरअसल सांताक्रूज के उस सांताक्रूज ईस्ट के उस रेस्टोरेंट में ज़्यादा मिले हुए थे, कैफे। कहते हैं मनुष्य सामाजिक प्राणी, मनुष्य सामाजिक प्राणी मतलब क्या भैया, समाज की ज़रूरत है। क्यों ज़रूरत है भैया, आप कुछ तो बोले, जैसे अब कहीं कुछ घट रहा है हम तो बोल सकते नहीं, चाहिए तो दोस्त चाहिए, और ऐसा दोस्त चाहिए जो जिसके लक्षण ये हो कि वो आप किसी अच्छी बात माने, गलत बातें उसको फेंक दें, वो बोले चले छोड़ दें, उसके लिए है लोग, क्रिटिक्स है, एनिमीज है। पर ये हमारा ऐसा दोस्त रहा जो मुझे ऐसा लगता है मैं केके के मतलब केके मैं जो तू कहना चाहता है वो भी कह रहा हूँ, पर तू अलग से कुछ कहना, कभी कभी पहले माइक मिल जाता है
अंग्रेजी में बोल देता हूँ
बस। देखो देखो ये है बात, इसलिए पहला माइक थैंक यू, इसके कहीं भी कॉर्नर में बैठे हंसते रहो। तो बात ये है कि अगर मित्र ना हो, देखो मैं आज मित्र के मतलब एक मित्र की हैसियत से बात कर रहा हूँ, रात सुबह मैं शायद हो सकता हूँ मुझे जी बोल दे, लेकिन मैं राइटर बना उसमें रात सुबह का और के सबसे ज़्यादा योगदान रहा। यहाँ पर एक और शख्स है मुझे ऐसा लगता है कि वो भी मानेगा, और वो है नौशिल मेहता, इफ इज देयर आई थिंक ही शुड आल्सो कम हियर। एंड ये ऐसे लोग होते हैं, हम कहते हैं कि राइटर नहीं है तो भैया दुनिया में घटती हुई कहानी कौन बताएगा, कहानी तो वो है कि मैंने कहीं तूने सुनी, तूने कहीं मैंने सुनी, और फिर ये हो गई मनमानी, चलो फिर बोल दो, ये कहता है जय गुरु, मैं कहता हूँ जय कहानी। और जय कहानी बोलने के लिए कोई तो होना चाहिए। अब मुझे ऐसा लगता है कि ये एक जो राइटर, अभी हमने कहा कि अगर किताब पढ़ लोगे तो आप स्पिरिचुअली बहुत आगे बढ़ोगे, स्पिरिचुअली आगे बढ़ोगे मतलब क्या होगा, ये हमेशा लोग डरते हैं कि स्पिरिचुअली आगे बढ़ोगे मतलब क्या, सलाम के अपने बाकी की चीज़ों से वैसे से दुख तो ना हो जाए। मुझे ऐसा लगता है व्हाट वी हैव बीन विद हिम, आई मीन लुक एट मी एज एक प्राणी की तरह आज भी है ना, इसके साथ रहा हूँ 20 साल से, फिर भी आज एक प्राणी लेकिन स्पिरिचुअल एक बैकबोन है जो उसकी बातों से हमें, अगर जैसे इसकी किताब के थ्रू हम परिचित हो जाएंगे अपने मित्र के किसी व्यक्ति से, मुझे ऐसा लगता है इस आदमी ने मुझे कम से कम दुनिया की बहुत खूबसूरत चीज़ों से मिलाया, और वहाँ पर मुझे ऐसा लगता है कि दोस्त होना अनिवार्य है। अगर मैं एक बात कहूँ, ईश्वर का मेरे लिए अगर कोई अमूल्य उपहार है, अगर कोई गिफ्ट, तो मुझे ऐसा लगता है कि दोस्त, और वो दोस्त अगर थिंकर और राइटर लोग शब्द होने चाहिए तो वो मुझे मिल गया है। और मैं चाहता हूँ कि ये ऐसी किताबें लिखे ताकि हम आज नहीं तो कल तो पूरी पढ़ पाए। देखो ये भाषा जो लिखता है आप समझ गया, ये ऐसी नहीं, चलो चलो ये भी पता चल गया, ये किताब ऐसी नहीं है सब लोग पढ़ सकते हैं, सबको सब कुछ समझ में आएगा, नहीं तो साथ में डिक्शनरी भी लेनी पड़ती है। पर इस बार नहीं है, ये है कि अपना करके कोई और भी सेल कर देगा हमारे, उधर बैठा ऐसे लोग ऐसे ही करते हैं। पर सच बताओ आई एम सो हैप्पी, कभी कभी आपको खुश होने के लिए अवसर मिलना पड़ता है, मुझे लगता है मेरे दोस्त ने आज मुझे ये अवसर दिया, और फरूख तूने तू नहीं होता तो ये होता नहीं। सो आई एम वेरी हैप्पी, थैंक यू फॉर कमिंग, हैप्पी न्यू ईयर, थैंक यू वेरी मच।
When the three of them were sitting in Cafe Luna, I was staying in Santa Cruz East Street. And on my way home, I used to see these three guys intent in conversation, intense every day, laughing, joking. And I always thought that they had maybe joined Karnoon. But one thing, maybe I'd be intruding. But I was so full of myself those days that I didn't really let that stop me, so I did join them. We were casual acquaintances in the beginning. I don't know when we became friends, but we became such strong friends that today I really enjoy their company and we are very close. Raj was normally quiet, silent, but when he talked, you listened. And that holds true even today. I'm glad I met him, I'm glad they're my friends, and I'm glad I get to read Raj's books. Raj, I'm glad I met him.
I would take you a bit further back in that case. I met Supe, I call him Supe, I don't call him formally Raj and all that. I met him at MBA, we did our MBA together at the Pune University. And after which, he went off to Delhi, I came to Mumbai, Bombay then. And Bombay, Hatsu ka shahar hai. So some accidents can be life destroying, some can be life preserving, depends on what kind of company you have. Luckily, Supe came back to Bombay. We got together and a few friends, we used to stay in this railway colony in Santa Cruz East. It was called 156x6, so it was popularly known as 156. And it was a kind of a dilapidated, any time a good fall kind of a structure. So yeah, we used to live there and we were very rich in thoughts, but not in the pocket. So that was our life. Supe was my image about Supe at that point in time is a man crouched over a table with stacks of books around, reading, writing, sometimes 20 hours at a stretch. So that is my first image that comes to me of yesteryears. And he used to have this notebook, you know, which he used to make notes from a book. And then after reading it, and then he used to pick up the book and say, "Yeh ho gaya." And those notes were the essence of his reading. And he used to literally devour books. He's read everything in life. And for a man like me, it was something too mammoth to even to imagine. I believe that God has given a particular skill as a gift to every human being. Be it writing or acting or carpentry, you know, or shoemaking for that matter. It's just that our desires sometimes don't match that. We go somewhere else and then we become mediocre. So with Supe, I had a very simple example. He would put pen to paper and start writing. He'd finish a page, and when you read that page, it is one of the most arresting kind of writing that you read. But the biggest aspect is that there is no scratches. There are no change of words, there are no change of phrases, there's no correction, it's as it is. So start to end is a neat piece of writing. And it needn't be philosophical all the time. You can tell him, "Supe, mall, liko," you know, he'll start writing. And that piece would be completely out of this world. Which goes to prove that he was born with that and God had given him that gift. I'm so glad that he has not returned that gift to God, saying that I'm going off to the Himalayas. He's continued with that writing and accepted the gift that God has given him, which I'm really thrilled to see. This is one such product. Now, his journey from being a literature bhakt to a spiritual bhakt happened right before all of us, all of us friends. And this transition was absolutely smooth, seamless, effortless and natural. Just like my transition of embracing him, hugging him like a friend, to now embracing him, hugging him and touching his feet. So it's that kind of a transition which has happened with me. So I'm really thrilled. There were times then, when we used to live in 156, that we used to never lock our door. So anybody was welcome. We had a small little party right at kind of one gadda there. And lots of books and tables, etc. So anybody was welcome, and we have many of them over here who have come there and visited. And that was life then, till he turned turtle. And went off to the Himalayas and did a good job of it, actually, you know. So that was Supe for me, and I'm so glad that I'm here. And I was there last time when we did Pick Up Park, and it's now one more book from him. I have read the book. It flows like water, and I think Ganga is the inspiration. So that's Raj Supe, my friend, philosopher and guru.
2 hours ago. Today, 2 hours ago, in Starbucks. So the connection is slightly older. Krishna Patel, right here, dear friend of mine, dear friend of Rajesh. A few months ago, she said, Benji, would you write the review of a book my friend has written? I had no idea who this friend was. Obviously, I had no idea that he had written many books before this one. But I jumped in and said yes. And then Raj sent me some excerpts from the book. I read them and I wrote back to him saying, Raj, look, I cannot write any kind of a review or anything, book or anything else, until I have read the entire thing in its entirety. He trusted me, he sent me the manuscript. I read it, some of it I read several times over, and then I wrote what I think more than a review, it is my reaction, my impressions of this. Of this wonderful book, When Life Turns Dull. The first time I've been introduced to writing of this kind. The only connection being that a little brief has been written by Mr. Ruskin Bond. Mr. Ruskin Bond and I went to the same school, different years with my senior at the Bishop Cotton School in Sydney. So there were the connections kept establishing themselves. Ruskin Bond, Bishop Cotton School, Simla, Hills, he lives in the hills, and so on and so forth. Two and two got together, and I attempted and wrote what I thought was a heartfelt appreciation of this wonderful book. And now, when I got the book in my hands a little while ago, I realized that Raj Sukhet had done me the singular honor of publishing that review as the foreword of this book, for which Raj thanked.
We have Ashutosh here with us, Ashutosh Gavalkar. A round of applause, he completes Cryo and he's now going to tell us his version of
Kapiluda.
Well, Ashutosh, we made sure we didn't launch the book without you. And we're so pleased to finally have you here with us because each of them were talking about their association with Raj, and we know you're a very integral part of that association. So if you could just share that with us before we move on to the book launch and the meeting.
Good evening. Sorry to hold the things up here. It's a very special moment for me to be here this evening, especially because of the launch of a very, very old friend who has always wanted to do something like this for many years, and finally he's come up with the book. My association with him was meeting him through a Prithvi camera, but what I discovered in him was a poet, a spiritual person, and was intense talent for writing. And that's the time I offered him to do the English transcreation of my songs of Swades and of Lodhartha, which he did so beautifully that one day Javed Saab called me and said, ki bhai, who has done the translation of the songs for the movie? Because till now, till that point in time, if you said Rang Barse would be color sprinkling. We would have very literal translations. But the way Raj had transcreated the songs, it was like a different poetry in itself, while doing full justice to Javed Saab's poetry. And he immediately included the songs, his songs, in his collection of poems, which is doing in English, which I thought was quite a commendable thing. And till this day, Raj, I think, has been for me someone who's always traveling, he keeps calling me out of the blue. And where are you now? Bangalore. Where are you now? Uttarkashi. Where are you now? Gangtok. I mean, he can be found in several places. So I'm really looking forward to reading this. When life turns turtle, I find the title so interesting because this is something that happens to us every 6 months in our business. So good luck, Raj. Thank you for inviting me and letting me know this happened. Because otherwise we tend to think that yaar, wo bahut busy hai, usko kyun bula hai, let him do his work. So I'm very happy to be talking and you. Thank you.
If you could just have one more replay of the teaser again, we can follow that by the launch and then the reading later.